pick up some utility bodies.
Some steel bodies?
Yeah.
They want nobody to be here till 9. I want them to go back there and
sit. Oh, okay. I guess I'll be back there sitting.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right, thanks. Well, that sucks. That means that I'm here at 7, and I'm going to be sitting here till 9 o'clock before they decide that they're going to do anything. Damn! What am I going to do? Shit. Probably a good idea to get some exercise, though, I'll tell you. Or go back to sleep, actually. I'm pretty tired. Such a beautiful morning out here. It sucks though because they're not gonna load me until, or even do anything until 9 o'clock. I got here at 7, which is, you know, when the lady on the phone yesterday told me, hey, they like to load during at daylight. So I'm thinking, okay, so what time should I be here? 6, 7, 8 o'clock? She's like, yeah, 7 o'clock. I'm like, cool. So boom, I'm here at 7 o'clock, right? This man's talking about 9 o'clock now. Damn. But look, so these are for wreckers, and here's a body for a wrecker right here. This is a wrecker, you know, you get your car towed or your truck towed, or maybe if you got a really big semi. But this is for, you know, this is for pretty heavy stuff though. But this body here, I guess they fabricate these bodies, diamond plate steel, and this is like, I don't think they build these, I think they order these. Somebody else manufactures the actual crane wrecker part with the hydraulics and whatnot, but they built the bodies though. They haven't painted it at all, so maybe I'll be getting one of these. Then they've got like a flatbed wrecker set up right here, so if you got like a class B flatbed wrecker, there's a body right there. So the bodies that they've got here, I've never actually hooked up to. So I'm sure they'll tell me what to do. Today's gonna be a learning experience, boys. What's up, man?
Where you heading to?
Iowa.
Iowa.
Yeah.
You know what you're getting?
Steel bodies.
Six.
Right, so I'm getting these. I'm getting six of these. I've never loaded these before, so this is gonna be fun. Remember when I said I think they only assembled the bodies for the wreckers, right? Well, they actually assemble and manufacture the cranes themselves too. Because look, this is all steel, square tube right here. Raw steel. And that's what turns into the wrecker. So here's like the hydraulic pumps right here. Or the hydraulic cylinders, I should say. And again, here's the steel framework, right, for the arms. Along with more. I'll get a phone call.
I'm going to make sure and hope that that will get me done on tomorrow afternoon.
You want rubber or you got stuff?
Rubber, please.
Hey, you remember that big sleeper truck that came through here a couple days ago?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm on the phone right
now. Oh, are you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He said he cracked his head open.
Did he?
Yeah, that's what he said.
So earlier I thought that I was gonna have to secure each one individually, but I called another person who does this all the time, and they said that all I need to do is throw three straps over the top of each three piece. So it's gonna be really easy. Straps. We're gonna throw straps. There's our rubber to protect the paint. Put you on a time lapse now. Anyways, what I was trying to say while the damn thing was rudely on time lapse was, we take this rubber right here and we put the rubber between the straps, so that way the straps themselves don't destroy the paint. See how I did that? Just like magic. Rubber under the strap to protect the paint. So let's get strapped up. Trojan man. All right, so here's the load. It took me about an hour to do this all. I've never done this before, this is my first time. So what I want you guys to do is, you know, let me know in the comments how you guys would have secured this, and let me know how I did, and let me know where I messed up and what I could have done better on. So we've got a pallet right here, a pallet right here, a pallet right here. And I've got 2-inch straps securing the pallets, right? We've got these three, stack of three, and these are for wreckers, flatbed wreckers. They got winches mounted to the front, you know what I mean? They've got the jaws back there, whatever. I've got 4-inch strap here with the rubber right here to protect the paint. 4-inch strap, there's dunnage, 4-inch strap. Again with the rubber to protect the paint. And that's on all of these. So this stack of three's got 3 4-inch straps. That stack of three has 4 4-inch straps. And they've got these header boards too that come with it. So what I did was I took a 2-inch strap right here. I really don't like how I did this, but you know, it's just what I threw together. I put rubber under here to protect the paint. 2-inch strap. Okay. 4-inch strap. These are 2 header boards. So I've got a 2-inch strap right here, and a 4-inch strap right here holding both of the header boards down. I put that 2-inch there because just so it won't move around or anything. I think the 4-inch is going to be fine, so it won't shift around, but I'll monitor that and see if it does. 2-inch strap for my bridges, for my ramps, not part of the load. 4-inch strap. I've got all this stuff really tight. Dunnage under there. My ramps are right here with this 2-inch strap. Okay. 4-inch strap, 4-inch strap. Again, with the header boards, I've got a 2-inch strap coming here, through here, right? Underneath this header board, over this piece here. Hopefully that doesn't hurt the paint right there. There's cardboard here, but there's none here. No rubber or anything there. And it goes to the other side. It's a 2-inch strap. I've got a 2-inch strap right here to hold it down. This, I'm hoping, doesn't shift at all. That's why I added this right here. Okay. And that, you can see that it's not even straight. I mean, it's crooked, but I can't get it to move. We'll just have to see how that rides. Okay, and I've got my 4-inch going there. Again, guys, you guys who are professionals, don't comment if you don't know nothing about it. I mean, you can comment if you want to. Just make sure you know what you're talking about. Because I'm a newbie, and I don't know what always. I don't always know what I'm talking about. So I try my best, though, right? So we just left the shipper. I mean, so we have got no miles on this load yet. So I'm curious to see how this thing rides. I can tell it's heavy. The weight is supposed to be 43,500 pounds. I think these will be okay. I mean, they're not too tight because I'm crushing the boxes, but I guess I'll check the load after 50 miles and see what I've got going on. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go ahead and measure to check my height, make sure I'm not too tall, and I'm not because I can look at the truck and see, but I have to write this kind of information down. So go ahead and get that done. Measure it. Take pictures of the load before I take off. And get to trucking, man. Geese.
All right. I guess it's time to check the load.
I don't like that at all.
I ain't gonna lie. This thing is moving. I'm gonna have to secure this. And it's crushing the boxes under here. So I'm gonna have to take care of this. I'm gonna run a 2-inch strap through the bottom of the pallet. This stuff's tight. Hey, I guess wherever I'm at is really cool because they've got a bunch of off-road vehicles out here. Oh, this is good. But they've got a ton of UTVs and four-wheelers and shit like that. Look at this. Everybody's got their four-wheelers. Just ride them up here. Going down, man. But so definitely gonna have to take care of them boxes up front, though. Oh, this is good. And then I gotta figure out how am I gonna turn around in here. this got very loose. I'm gonna have to see what's going on, and I still gotta figure out how to turn around. I'm in a terrible spot. You know what I'll do? I'll just back straight up into that fuel station and pull out. We got dirt bikes out here too, man. So this one's loose. I'm gonna have to figure that out. Everything else is tight, and then I gotta take care of these pallets. Everything's looking good other than this pallet. This pallet looks like shit. So what's happened is the shit has shifted forward. So I'm gonna run 2-inch straps under there. So let me go ahead and get that taken care of. Okay, so here's what I've done with the boxes, right?
So these straps are a little bit loose. They come loose. I gave them a little crank. I ran another 2-inch strap right here, going to the rail. I took the looseness, what is that called? The slack. Got a nice tucked away in here. And I ran the ratchet right here. It's up against this rubber, up against this 4-inch strap, so it's not touching the, it is touching it right here. I'll put something there. I'm gonna put some John Wayne right there. I've got the 2-inch strap running up across the top of those box right here. This is a separate pallet. This is a separate pallet. That's a separate pallet. And I've run the 2-inch strap up and over and underneath into under through the pallet. So that way, when it pulls, it's not only pulling it down, but it's pulling it backwards and holding it backwards. And here it comes across here. And I've got it hooked up here. Okay. So I've tightened up those two ratchets right there. Plus put that third one through the pallet. That shouldn't be a problem anymore. I tightened up, this 2-inch ratchet right here because it had come loose somehow. And everything else is tight. I haven't had to tighten up anything else. So what I'm gonna do now, right there where that, you seen that 2-inch rubbing against the paint. There it is right here. That's too much though, I need a little piece.
Okay. All right, and that should just about do it. Where is it? Right there, okay.
Now it's time for me to back up all the way under to the shell so I can pull out and get on the hell out of here.
And we'll also check the load again because obviously you want to check your load.
Yo, I don't know if I got this from running in here, but I got a freaking screw in my tire and it is leaking air.
Screw in my front tire, I literally just pulled out, and right there on my Trucker Path app, it showed a truck stop with a CAT scale, and sure enough, it's a TA. So like, I literally just drove right across the street to TA, and we're gonna see if we can't get a new tire, because I don't think you'd want to repair a front tire like that. I don't think they even do that. You
after 600 feet, turn left and then enter the highway towards.
Ciao. Hey, I don't know what's going on over here with the cops. Those are cops right there chilling. And there's a car hauler right there. And they just sitting there chilling. I don't know.
After 400 feet, enter the highway.
I've not seen that before.
Now enter the highway.
Up in here and
get her done, and I'm gonna finally get my low beam taken care of too.